first up is Gatekeeper. Parker, tell us about Gatekeeper.
Gatekeeper is the new wing coaster at Cedar Point this year in beautiful Sandusky, Ohio. The stat sheet's on it, stuff that I don't really care about. Track length, yay, it's long. 164-foot vertical drop, not bad. 2 minute 40 second ride time, solid ride time, 67 miles per hour. Capacity approximately 1,700 riders an hour. They're gonna be rocking the 3 train all summer long, so that'll be fun. I listen to a lot of the different podcasts. I read the different news trades. What do you think of it? It's been getting a lot of kind of like, it's just another wing coaster.
I've ridden X, and I know it's a wing coaster. It's not a next dimension coaster like X is, but it's like they all just kind of have this kind of like, because of the design of the actual trains, it seems very hard to get the G-forces and the maneuvers that you can get out of a lot of different type of coasters. So it's, I think more of the thrill is just you're hanging off the side of the track more than, you know, the maneuvers and the G's you're going to get or airtime or anything like that. I mean, that keyhole in front of the park seems to be kind of the trademark of the wing coaster. Every single one has it. Seems like the necessary element you must have in a wing coaster in order to, you know, open it. Because if you don't have it, they're just going to take you away and shut you down for not. But what's cool is that it's going to be the coaster right in the front of the park. It's a beautiful location. It looks like it's on the beach. Beautiful views from the ride, from the entrance. And you know you're going to see all the little kids just sitting there outside the gate just pounding to get in because it's going to be right there above them, you know, beckoning them to come in and ride.
I'm excited about it. I mean, they're getting a whole new entrance, so that's great. They've needed this for a while. Those old ticket buildings were bad. I mean, they had, like, the individual AC units in the building. And so, you know, like, if you got someone in there sweating all day selling tickets, you know, crank that sucker up. But other than that, they were just old little buildings. Like I said, they're completely rebuilding the entrance to this place. It's going to look great. Like you said, the coach are flying over the entrance. It's going to be spectacular. And being on the beach, it does add another element of awesomeness, as far as I'm concerned. So I believe it's going to be a great coaster. I think it's going to be a hit. I hope it doesn't let me down.
And I think it looks like it's going to be fun. Like, I'll ride it. And I don't think it's going to be one of those that, like, I don't think it's going to stand the test of time for decades. I think for several seasons, it'll be the solid anchor to drag people into the park.
Now, let's say me and you, for some reason or another, we're given, like, an access pass to go to Cedar Point, and we get to walk on any one ride we want there. Is this the ride that you go to because it's new, or do you still choose one of the other ones?
I'd probably be going on Millennium Force or one of the record holders or something like that, just because it's, you know, it's standing the test of time and not just the new hotness, so.
Yeah, I'm running to the back of the park to get on Millennium Force to try and see if I can knock my hand on one of those poles that are way too close to the track. Too much fun.
So, speaking of knocking your hand off random parts of theme parks, let's talk about Full Throttle, because that's the new one at Magic Mountain that is just taking over the park. I was there a couple months ago, and the construction for that sucker is everywhere. Like, it's at the entrance, it's over Superman, it's in the old monorail tunnels, they demolished the log ride to put it in. Like, Full Throttle is just going to be, like, all over Magic Mountain. It's just track everywhere. Everywhere.
Full Throttle is going to be huge. I've never been to Magic Mountain, I gotta tell you. I've never been there. The only thing I've done is I've watched the YouTube video several times. We'll put it on the Facebook page. We'll tweet it. But this Full Throttle thing, I'm saying it's a gimmick. I'm saying it's the biggest.
Totally. 100% is a gimmick. Like, if you do any of the ride-throughs, like, you, especially when you look at the Magic Mountain, like, CGI edit of the ride-through, they recut, like, the same elements, like, 2 or 3 times to make it look like it's a longer ride. It's like a minute 10, minute 30, something like that is the projected ride time. And they say 3 launches. Well, one of them's the backwards launch back into the exact same launch to go over the top hat, which it's a loop. And
it's a loop.
The end. It's a loop. Then you loop around, you go over the loop, and then you're in the station. Like, so, okay, so it's going to have the 160-foot vertical loop, which is supposed to be the tallest steel looping coaster constructed ever in all of humanity, which, cool, very cool. So you're gonna launch up into that, loop around, go up over Superman into one of the old monorail tunnels, stop, go backwards into the element you just went a little slower, and then zip back through it again to launch over the top of the 160-foot loop, like a top hat style. So loop, you're going over it, and then brake run into the station.
Immediate into the brake run. We have brake run going like, down the other side of the loop right now. Like, yeah. Huge brake run. to me, honestly, two very important questions. One, well, three. Are they going to run more than one train at once? It's Magic Mountain. It's Magic Mountain.
No, it's Magic Mountain. No, they won't.
Two, is the mist going to work in the tunnel? I've ridden so many rides that this attraction features mist and lights and everything else, and maybe even an elephant. They never show up, especially the elephant. I rode Safari. It's not there. Fix it.
The elephant's gone from the Safari. Just
the third, is there ever going to be a time where there's a coaster going in the loop and over the top hat at the same time?
No. Just the dispatch intervals, because the ride's not that long.
No.
At best, you get something launch. If you get your timing just right, you get something launching out of that tunnel and it launching out of the station at the same time. But that duration's like 30 seconds in between. So it's only a minute and a half ride. So you got to load the next train and get it launched within 30 seconds to hit that two trains on the loop at the same time, which... it's possible?
It's possible. Unless they're going all out on this thing and they're like, you know what? There's going to be a sensor in the tunnel that when it does the first backwards, will load the train out. And then when they launch, they'll hit the same.
Which it's Six Flags.
So Six Flags.
Even if that's loaded in there, it's going to be turned off. Because that you'd have to fix it. And no.
Just for the record, Six Flags, total big fan of the all-you-can-eat diner pass. I heard on the, there's another podcast that talked about this. The one in New Jersey, if you live near New Jersey, it was like $60 or whatever for the whole summer. It was cheaper to buy a season pass and one of these passes and go and eat there every day than it is to buy groceries. So thanks, Six Flags.
But if you're going to go to the park, you know, and use that pass, get the food,
We're going to talk about food a lot over the duration of this and food. Food.
All you can eat theme park wristband passes, whatever, are probably the greatest invention mankind has ever done.
Universal is doing it right, as far as I'm concerned. That's all I want to say about that. Moving on, what do we got next?
Let's talk about Universal, because there's a big old robot fighting robot building going on in the middle of Florida that like a year ago wasn't there, and now it's going to open in like a couple months.
Not only is this thing going down in the middle of Universal Studios Florida, this thing's going in the middle of New York.
Yes, because, well, where else are robots going to fight but the middle of New York in a studio park where WrestleMania is filmed on the left side and it's New York City on the right side?
I'm not going to lie, I'd rather see a robot fight Jaws.
Unfortunately, a wizard has taken care of Jaws for you, so that's already done.
It's true, it's gone.
They're building a clone of the Hollywood Transformers ride in Universal Studios Florida right now, which... awesome ride. I rode it in Hollywood many, many times. It's epic. It uses the exact same ride system as Spider-Man, which is next door up to Universal Studios Florida at Universal Islands Adventures in Orlando. And which, very, very cool ride system, very cool experience. Spider-Man is definitely the better of the two. Spider-Man is a much, you know, bigger building, bigger screens, animatronics, explosions, much kind of grander scale, whereas... Transformers is a much smaller, tight space, so it's, you get the same 3D and the same motion, but the screens are a lot closer, and it's not quite the same grand experience. Like, they use the 3D and the screens a lot more than what Spider-Man does throughout the ride. While Spider-Man still uses it a lot, Transformers, that's all it is you're right there in the screen and bouncing around. So my biggest question has always been, why? I don't see why you would build it in Universal Studios Florida when you got Spider-Man right there at Islands Adventure, other than it's super cool and we can build it fast and it's going to, you know, fill that attendance space in between Harry Potter 2, which is currently under construction in the former Jaws side in the back of the park.
But Harry Potter 2 is going to take you on a train ride from Transformers to Spider-Man. We're gonna take you from... we're going to take a train ride from Dumbo to Aladdin's Flying Carpets. That's what we're going to do.
It's a little more elaborate than that. Just slightly. I mean, all respect to Dumbo, because it's Dumbo. But I have a feeling that Transformers and Spider-Man are still a little bit better than Dumbo.
Agreed.
But you're not.
So yeah, anyway, Transformers, middle of the park. It's going to be at the exit to Shrek in a giant army bunker that is in a working studio.
I don't get it. I don't think they needed it when they built a big pit and everybody was like, what the heck's going on here? And all of a sudden everyone's like, ah, it's Transformers. It's going to be Transformers. I stopped caring at that point. I'm more interested in Potter. There's a roller coaster going on in the background. Let's talk about that. Let's do that.
Gringotts is going to be awesome. Like, I know very little about it other than, I mean, there's talks about it being a coaster with that locks into a motion base at some point. It's going to be indoors, which that can only be cool. And I'm with you. Like, I am staring at Harry Potter expansion in the back of Universal Studios Florida, just waiting for that. And I think Transformers is totally just the, hey, Disney, look at all the stuff we're building. We got our lock. I mean, Harry Potter 1 was so successful in Universal Studios Islands Adventure that Harry Potter 2 is only going to be better and bigger. And Transformers is just kind of like the, well, you know, we got some time, we got some space, so let's just throw up something else because we just want to make it, you know, awesome.
Let's move on to the...
Let's talk about Avatar Land and Animal Kingdom.
Okay.
That is totally 100% happening because Disney said so.
Because it's happening. Joe Rhodes has taken the 15th anniversary weekend off because even he can't believe that it's still happening. Read that all over WDWmagic.com this week. That's their big headline news. Let's talk about Avatar Land. Let's, you know, what have you read about it? Do you think it's real? Do you think it's crazy? What do you? Let's talk about it.
I think something eventually will be built where Camp Minnie Mickey is. I mean, obviously they're moving Lion King as we speak. They're building a new stage for the Festival of the Lion King back behind Tusker House in Africa, which, yay for moving to Africa, because it's lions and it takes place in Africa, so naturally deserves to be in an American day camp. So it's going to Africa, which will be, you know, much better than where it's at now and make more sense. And hopefully they use some of the really cool Hong Kong Disneyland theater effects where they have the stages that move up, because if you haven't seen the video of Hong Kong Disneyland's Festival of the Lion King, it's awesome. Same show, but just more effects and...
They build a show rather than just have the leftover parade floats.
Yeah, exactly. For if you don't know, Festival of the Lion King was one of those temporary attractions to get Animal Kingdom through its first year. It's using the old Disneyland parade floats from the Festival of the Lion King parade that was forever ago when the Lion King came out as a movie. And it worked. And it's become one of the most popular daytime shows in the Disney property. So they can't... They're keeping it for sure. And... Now it's just relocating because it's, I mean, they do that show, what, like 1,000 times a day?
Is this the show's third house?
Yeah, because they started with the original outdoor theater, then they enclosed that theater, and now it's the third, yeah, it's the third house for it.
It's getting around.
So that's being moved, which no matter what they put where Camp Minnie Mickey is, that had to happen because obviously Festival of the Lion King isn't going anywhere in the immediate future. It's over a decade old and still packing the house, so it's going to keep going. They just, if they're going to build Avatar Land or any other new addition to Animal Kingdom, Camp Minnie Mickey is the place to do it. They just need to get Lion King out of there, which step one's happening. Now the question of, is Avatar actually going to be the thing that goes there? We'll see. I mean, Disney says it is, so Disney would never lie to us, right?
What's going on? What do you think is there? What would you like to see? Let's be weird.
I don't know. Like I'm a decent fan of Avatar. Like I like the movie. I'm not like, you know, a crazed fan or think it's the second coming like some people do. I've seen a lot of things online where people are speculating it's going to be a simulator ride with a boat ride going through it, which I can get. I'm not really excited for another simulator. Like, I don't care what type it is. I mean, granted, Avatar is known for its visuals and the 3D and all that sort of stuff, which would make for a cool film-based attraction. I just don't think with Spider-Man and Transformers going in and already having Soarin' at Epcot that another flat-out simulator, single-screen attraction is really the best idea for, you know, a $500 million expansion for Animal Kingdom.
I'm with you there. Don't get me wrong. I love the idea of like a small world type version boat ride to get people on board with a, in case you missed the $1 billion movie, here's what you're dealing with. And we just kind of rope you through it.
I think the premise behind Avatar, the whole, you know, nature connection, the one with, you know, animals and all that kind of, that Avatar preaches, is completely in line with the theme of Animal Kingdom. I'm just curious as to what the actual e-ticket ride is going to be.
If this place is going to take up the place of Beastly Kingdom, and it's going to take up all this land and a multi-billion dollar investment, this thing needs to wow me. And I don't think a simulator is the right thing. I'm with you on the no simulator thing. And if it is a simulator, it better be Storm Rider on crack with, like, Figment showing up somewhere in the middle of it. And just all kinds of awesomeness that people are just, when they come out of it, their hair's blown back. They're like, oh my gosh, that was insane.
If you're going to spend $500 million on an expansion, which is what they're rumored to be spending on Avatar Land if it ever starts, which that's the same as a Cars Land budget. I mean, with California Adventure and Cars Lands, we got, you know, the epic Cadillac Range and Radiator Springs Racers and Luigi's Flying Tires and Mater.
We got the best new attraction in the world. Toe Maters. Junkyard Jamboree.
Here's my thing. If Avatar does happen, I hope it's some. If they figure out maybe something in the second or third movie that's a better attraction base than a simulator. I'm kind of hoping they just don't do Avatar Land.
What if they did a movie, like, instead of doing a movie like they wanted it to, they're like, we got to build a ride out of this. So let's make it ride-worthy and then just forget it happened and then make the last one and just ride. I feel like it's the Matrix trilogy. We made the first one, it rocked, and then we made two more, and we didn't want to talk about those, but we got the first one. Well, I think that about does it for this week. If you haven't already liked the video, please do. We appreciate it. Also, you can follow us on Twitter at Theme Park Nerds. And also, we have a Facebook page?
We do have a Facebook page. You can like us on Facebook, Theme Park Nerds. Just click that little like button. We'd appreciate it.
Just click it. That's all for this week. We'll try and keep you updated on when we're going to do more updates. It was great talking to you guys. Have a good week.
See you later, guys.